let's talk about increasing a podcast audience. And Leia, you have a podcast called
The Well-Being Room.
Yeah, with a professional mic and everything too. All right, so increasing a podcast audience essentially is, you know, the two things. I'll just give you two ideas, okay? Real simple. One, most people increase their podcast audience by using interviews with as famous of people as they could possibly interview that would say yes. And when people they interview who have an audience, they themselves, the person who's being interviewed, might share the episode with their audience, and their audience therefore discovers your podcast. But also, if the person is relatively well known, their audience, their large audience, is just searching the web for them and may come across your podcast, especially if you can put your interviews on YouTube.
Yeah.
Because if you do so, then especially if you put their name in the front of the YouTube video title, YouTube is very well search engine optimized, meaning when people search so-and-so's name, the YouTube videos often come up that are recent videos. And so they'll, oh, so-and-so was interviewed, let me check this out. And then they'll discover your podcast through the YouTube video. So interviewing people is a popular way. Another way you could say maybe that was 1A. 1B, all right, 1A is interviewing famous people or as much as you can get up there. 1B is being interviewed on other people's podcasts. And when you're interviewed, make sure you mention that you have a podcast because, well, of course, if someone is listening to a podcast interview of you, they're a podcast listener. So they're more likely to say, well, gosh, I like Leia. Well, let me check out Leia's podcast as well. So 1A, interviewing people as famous as you can get. 1B, being interviewed if it's possible. And then method number two is running paid ads. And so let's talk about running paid ads. You know, it's actually getting more and more common for people to run paid ads on other people's podcasts, promoting one's own podcast. So something to consider, but that means you have to either get into some kind of, I think there are podcast networks where there are, you can do ads. I don't know of any, by the way, so you might have to research this. Or you run ads on other platforms like Facebook, Instagram, or YouTube, LinkedIn, Twitter, etc., promoting your podcast. Now, when you run an ad promoting your podcast, you could either run an ad promoting podcast in general, or you run an ad promoting a specific episode that is just, well downloaded, meaning the topic was very interesting for people. So this is why I would invite you to look at your own podcast download stats and say, well, which episode was downloaded the most? Because the problem with the podcast is we can't tell if people really enjoyed it, right? There's no like enjoyment meter for a podcast. Like social media posts, you can like something. Podcast, you have no idea. All you know is that people downloaded it. And why did they download it? Because the title sounded good. That's why they downloaded it. So similarly, if you advertise a podcast episode where the title sounds good, you're more likely to get people clicking through and listening to the podcast and then subscribing to it. But go ahead, Leia.
I can show you my stats if you want.
If you want to share, sure, that'd be great. Yeah. And thank you for being willing to do that. And apologies for my lighting here. It's getting to be evening. And so it's kind of getting darker here. But Leia, I'm grateful for your good lighting. Okay, cool. Okay, so first 7 days of the last 13 episodes. That's interesting. That's actually quite helpful. So essentially what we're looking at is in the first week that each episode was released, right? In the first week each episode was released, how many times was it downloaded? And that's a reliable stat for, well, how interesting was the episode title, which means, well, which ones might we? Okay, let's scroll down and take a look. Okay, so episode 12, Food Energetics with Kimberly Ashton. I imagine she probably shared it, maybe that's, well, didn't get that many downloads.
I don't know. I don't think she did. I mean, I shared it on Instagram and Facebook.
Yeah. Oh, okay, cool. Well, if you my gosh, if you look, go down here, actually, the first 7 days of each episode, welcome.
We
can basically get rid of the first two episodes, meaning because you were launching the podcast, so naturally people are going to listen to the first one the most. So yeah. Starting with episode 3 and onward, we could see that there is a natural downward trend in the beginning before people mm-hmm. really discover your podcast. Like in the beginning, it's your friends and family listening.
Yeah.
Right. And then once people discover it, then kind of like there's this U curve, like friends and family, and then like friends and family stop listening to it. And then it gets discovered. It starts going back up. So as we can see, aging gracefully seems to be a popular topic. I mean, if you look at the numbers, that one had a spike, you know, and then I would say the other spike, I mean, episode 3, maybe, but it might still be benefiting from the launch halo effect. So aliveness, that's probably a pretty good one. So I think, just if I were just to pick one, I would say aging gracefully right now. And then you'll need more and more stats for you to know which ones are really working. Now food energy, I would say food energetics. I mean, if episodes, if really the last couple months, like the single digits is the norm right now, we could still compare, right? It's like 8, 6, 8, 5. Well, gosh, you know, food energetics, I would say, is another peak in the, when we're comparing those months.
So then you're saying I should be promoting those episodes over the other ones.
I would say try running 2 ads, right? One ad would be promoting the podcast in general. To say, these are the kinds of topics I'm going to cover. Sorry, my lighting is terrible. But these are the kinds of topics I'm going to cover.
You're in a cave, George.
Yeah, what's that? I'm in a cave.
You're in a cave.
Yeah. This is why I do podcasts. No. I have lighting good enough for podcasts. Okay. So that's one type. And then the second type is the specific episode. I would say the Aging Gracefully would be a good one. So,
Thank you.
Yeah. Great.